I'm Ashley. Thanks for coming. Today's big idea is Jesus beat death. Jesus was crucified, but 3 days later, he rose from the grave, defeating death and paying for our sins. Ready to start? Let's go.
Sweat hit the ground, I put my foot in the block. This is the race of my life, and I can't wait for this shot. Cause I can feel the wind at my back, chest is pumping like a heart attack. Feet are moving and my mind is locked, pressing on with everything I got. He's a maverick.
Like I care.
A nonconformist. He broadcasts and retransmits sporting events without the express written consent of the NFL. He never, ever waits 30 minutes after a meal to swim. He tampers with smoke detectors in airplane lavatories. He hates all authority.
Son, hold the line.
No.
Sweetie, eat these cookies.
No.
He is the most rebellious teen alive.
Sir, would you please follow me?
You are not the boss of me.
Out of control. He does what no one else does.
Are you actually reading the terms and conditions? No one reads those.
I know. Why do you think they call me Super Rebel?
Okay.
cash me outside. How about that?
Come on, man. Silence your phone.
Silence your face.
Excuse me? Silence my what?
He's a super rebel.
Have a nice day, sir.
Don't tell me what to do.
Because everyone else is a big, fat, stupid head.
Look both ways, man. You look both ways.
He doesn't look both ways before crossing a street. Nothing can stop him. He's Super Rebel, and he's gonna rock your world.
No, I'm not.
I'm Bobby and I grew up on my family's farm. I moved to the big city, let adventure take me far. It's Hobbies with Bobby, Bobby, yeah!
This is Hobbies with Bobby.
Oh, hi there. Good to see you again. Welcome to my house in the city. I just got back from dance rehearsal. Whew, we've been practicing for a huge dance competition, but I don't think we're gonna win. Oh, for starters, the last 3 years in a row, we have lost to the team from Granite Hills. They wear all black and they're super, super intimidating. Then, this week, our best dancer, Jessica, sprained her ankle really bad. It doesn't look like she's even going to be able to dance with us in the final competition. I feel super sad about it. One of the things I learned when I was at church, like you are right now, is that I can go to the Bible no matter how I'm feeling. Let's see if there's a story that can teach us something today.
It's Bible time, time for the Bible, yeah!
It's Bible time with Bobby.
This story is from the book of Matthew. Last week, we learned about how Jesus trusted God, even though that meant he'd be killed by the people who didn't think he was the Son of God. But Jesus trusted God and made the sacrifice that showed the whole world how much he loved us. This story this week picks up after Jesus was killed by the rulers and buried in the tomb. On the third day, friends of Jesus who were women went to the tomb to take care of his dead body. But when they got there, his dead body was gone. There was an earthquake. Then an angel came down and spoke to them. Matthew 28:5-6 says, "The angel said to the women, 'Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay.'" Wow! They looked in and Jesus was gone. So they ran and told more of Jesus' followers that Jesus had beat death. Jesus had come back from the dead. That must have been so encouraging for Jesus' friends and disciples. Even when they thought there was no chance for success, that they for sure had lost, that is when God pulled out the victory. Well, now I'm off to our dance competition. I'm going to remember that lesson from last week, that if Jesus can trust God, then so can I. And all we can do is try our best, even if we don't have our best dancer, Jessica. Wish me luck. Look at this! We did it! Jessica's ankle healed up and the doctor said she could dance in the competition. She was amazing and our team had a lot of fun dancing together. Even when no one else thought we can win, we were able to do the improbable. And afterwards, we met our rivals, the team from Granite Hills, and they weren't that bad after all. I guess this is a lot like the Bible story. Jesus beat death, which even his closest friends didn't think he could do. The biggest win that ever was won is in Jesus Christ. Jesus beat death to give everyone life. I'm so glad you could be with me this week. Next week, come hang out and we can try another hobby together. See you soon.
This is Hobbies with Bobby.
Hey there! Have you ever played a game where you had to save the world? Maybe you pretended to be a superhero, or a cool animal, or a plumber with a pet dinosaur. It's pretty fun to pretend to save the world, but did you know that someone really did save the world? In real life? It was Jesus! Here's how it happened. A long time ago, Jesus died on a cross. He was buried in a tomb, and then he rose from the dead. Because he died and then came back to life, Jesus made a way for you and me to be forgiven, be rescued, and be close to God forever. But at first, when Jesus died, his friends didn't understand. They were so sad. They couldn't believe he was gone. 3 days after Jesus died, two of his friends, both named Mary, went to visit the place where Jesus' body was. But when they got there, they were in for a big surprise. Jesus' body was gone. Sitting on top of the stone was an angel, his clothes as bright as lightning, who had a message for Jesus' friends.
He's not here. He has risen, just like he said.
The women were overcome with joy and ran to tell the others. They wanted everyone to know Jesus was alive. The news Mary and Mary ran to tell that first Easter is the same news we can celebrate today. Jesus isn't dead. He is risen and alive. Because Jesus beat death, we can be forgiven and be with God forever.
The story of Easter. Jesus' sacrifice. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
The Jewish leaders and teachers did not like what Jesus was doing or how he claimed to be the Son of God. And so they made a plan to arrest him to get rid of him once and for all. Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, agreed to betray Jesus.
Come in.
And give him over to the religious leaders for some money. Jesus was in a garden praying, and Judas showed the man who Jesus was. Jesus was arrested and taken to the rulers of the land so that they could decide what to do with him. Jesus was presented before the high council, and they asked him if he was the Messiah, the Savior of the Jews. They asked him if he was claiming to be the Son of God. You say that I am. And the council was furious, and they shouted that Jesus was guilty and he deserves to die. So they took Jesus before the Roman ruler Pilate, and he heard the case against Jesus. Pilate didn't think that Jesus had done anything wrong.
Seemed okay to me.
They found him to be innocent, so Pilate said that he would punish Jesus and then release him.
What?
But the crowd kept screaming louder and louder, "Crucify him! We want him dead!" And because of the pressure of the crowd, Pilate turned Jesus over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Jesus was hurt and spit on. His clothes were torn and taken from him, and a crown made out of thorns was put on his head. He was beaten so badly that he could barely stand on his own. And then he was forced to carry his cross so far up a mountain that he needed help because he could not do it on his own. Once Jesus made it to the place where he would be crucified, called the Skull, the soldiers around him nailed him to the cross and waited for him to die. While Jesus was hanging on the cross, many people shouted to him, "If you really are the Son of God, save yourself from the cross." But Jesus knew he had to die to forgive his people for their sins. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. 3 hours later, Jesus took his last breath and finally died. At that very moment, the curtain in the temple that separated the priests from God's holy place tore in two. A soldier watching the whole thing said, "This man truly was the Son of God." Then a righteous man named Joseph came and placed Jesus' body in a tomb. 3 days passed, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body and found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. "Don't be afraid," said an angel. "He is not here. He is risen." At this, the woman remembered that Jesus had told them that he would rise again on the third day.
Woohoo!
And ran to go tell the disciples what they had seen and heard.
Huh?
Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Jesus was treated so badly. The people were so angry with Jesus that they arrested him and put him on the cross. It was terrible. All of Jesus' friends were so sad because they loved Jesus and they thought they'd never see Jesus again. But what happened 3 days later? This is why we celebrate Easter. We celebrate Easter because Jesus is alive. Jesus beat death. John 3:16 through 17 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believed in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him." Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sins. This way, we can be with God one day in heaven. Let's pray. God, thank you for sending Jesus to earth to beat death and to forgive me. Thank you for loving us that much. We love you. Amen. Parents, find lesson materials in the description box below. Thanks for coming, and I'll see you next week. Oh, before I forget, if you're not signed up for the DK monthly subscription, you can go to discoverdestiny.org/kids or scan the QR code below. Make sure to opt in to get a free gift at the beginning of each month.